everyone. I hope that you're doing well. You can probably hear that my allergies are really getting to me. Hopefully that you're not facing something similar, that you're feeling well and that you're able to enjoy the sunshine and the warmth. I wanted to check in. We're halfway done with Unit 6 and we're nearly done with the class. So the semester is almost over. The last day of class is Friday, April 23rd. So please make note of that. The final project is due by 11:59 midnight on Friday, April 23rd. Also, any late work or things that you're still trying to catch up on that you haven't quite finished yet, all of that is due by that date and time. Because that's the end of the course, I have to get final grades together and submit feedback on all of the work that you've done. Quickly thereafter, that is the final deadline. I can't accept work after that. So please do plan ahead for that. I think we have a good looking 3 weeks left of our course. This week you'll be joining in the discussions of Ayu Rigoberta Menchu on Brightspace. So you need to choose two of the three discussions. Choose the two that are most interesting to you, that you most want to engage with. The idea behind all of them, excuse me, is that they will give us an opportunity to think a little bit more deeply about the testimonial account of Rigoberta Menchu in preparation for that option for the final project. And so all of us will need to engage with the book in some way, shape, or form. If you do those discussions, they should help you to think about that larger question that is asked in the final project instructions. So all that to say, be planning ahead for the final project. Once we're done with Unit 6, the end of this week, so this coming Sunday, you'll have almost 2 full weeks, not quite, but almost 2 full weeks to spend on the final project. There is an optional extra credit timeline assignment if you want to do that. There's time a little bit to catch up on things you may have missed, and hopefully this provides you a little bit of breathing room, because I know you have more than just my class going on and at CNM. You also have a lot of other responsibilities in your own lives and things like that. So hopefully this will help things kind of work out so that we can all finish the course strongly this semester. If you have any questions about the two final project options, please don't hesitate to ask. Look at the final projects folder at the end of the course content section in Brightspace. So it's one of the folders beneath all of the various units. There's the Twitter and timeline tutorials, and then there is a final project and extra credit section. That's the one I'm talking about when I'm talking about the folder. So click there to see the guidelines for both the Menchu essay and the También la Lluvia review. And you can read those, ask me questions, decide which one you want to pursue. I've enjoyed interacting with your reading responses on the Unit 6 materials. So we weren't just reading Rigoberta Menchu, but we were also focusing on Chapter 12 in Wood and Alexander about historical memory and trying to come to terms with grave acts of violence that have been committed with the support of the state. In places like Guatemala. You know, the focus is on Guatemala, but this story, unfortunately, is much broader than that. You know, Chile, Argentina, Brazil, even Mexico have to reckon with these histories of dirty wars, whether they were blatant and actually called the dirty wars, as in the case of Argentina and Brazil, or if they were somewhat hidden, as in the case of Mexico, although there was still intense violence in places like Guerrero. In the 1960s and 1970s, it just wasn't kind of recognized in the same way at the time. So we'll be thinking about things like why and how do testimonial accounts like Rigoberta Menchu's help us, or help not just us to understand and get international attention, but also help the people of Menchu's own K'iche' section of the Maya people, other Mayan peoples and linguistic groups and cultural groups, other indigenous people throughout the region, and so on. How do those kinds of testimonies help to promote the restoration of human rights and reconciliation. Think about what are the limitations of that. But again, this is a huge issue. It's very painful, very problematic, and it's a legacy of the Cold War neoliberal policies. I should say Cold War and neoliberal policies, although they did dovetail, that we were studying in Unit 5, many of which the United States was complicit in, whether covertly or overtly. And so we also should think about, as citizens of the United States and people who are living here, what role should we play in trying to help to reconcile some of these things? All right, so those are we're left with big questions, difficult questions that people are still grappling with across Latin America. Scholars are still grappling with, the people who have lived the experiences are still grappling with. And that's where our class kind of ends up. So those are the big issues we'll be tackling over the next few weeks. If you're interested in a little extra credit, in the activity feed, I'll post a question about the Chastine book. I'll probably also ask about Wooden Alexander. Mostly, I'm just curious about your experiences using those texts as the kind of primary drivers for our course, what your thoughts are about them, what other things you might want to see. So I'd love to get your feedback, and I'm happy to give you some extra points for indulging me and responding to those questions. All right, I hope you're having a good Monday, and I'll talk to you soon.